evening, and welcome to the Greater Columbus Arts Council's 2024 Big Arts Night.
Hey, come on, put your hands together like this. Woo! It hit me like dynamite while I was healing from the black and blue. Worry about a thing that I never had, or focus on what I do. With a little bit of love and a little bit of time, I found out what was true. I got a good love. Hey, say, I got a good life. Say, hey, hey, I got a good life. Ow, like the lips on a honeybee. Ooh, you taste so sweet. Nothing better than you and me. How could it be? Whoa, whoa, whoa. I must be doing something right to have it end up here with you. I know there's been a few bumps and a few hard nights, but I'm thankful, hey. With a little bit of time, the sun came shining through. I know the good life. Come on, hey. I got the good life. Hey. Right here we say, never knew how much it meant to have you in my life. You fill my heart with the missing pieces. How could it be? Hey, hey. Oh, the good life. Oh, the good life. Oh, the good life. Hey. I got the good life. I got the good life. I got the good life. Hey, I got the good life.
I think I need more love. Hi. Hi, Michael. I'm going to start pointing out people that I know in the audience now and embarrassing them because I got dirt on all y'all. Good evening, party people. And welcome to the Greater Columbus Arts Council's Big Arts Night, or as I like to call it, even though Tom Katzenmeyer loses color in his face when I say it, the Big Ass Arts Night. All right, first of all, let's have a big round of applause for one of my favorite musicians and just favorite people on the planet. I've known him since he was a teenager, the amazing Quan Howell. You see, he tried to outdress me, right? You're going to get to hear more from Quan and his group later on, and I guarantee you, you will be dancing, yeah. For those of you who don't know, shame on you, but I am Angela Pace, and I am delighted to once again serve as your queen for our third annual Big Arts Night. Now, tonight, first of all, we were having some technical difficulty. Again, we're having technical difficulty. Prompter. All right, so I'm just going to stand here and let y'all admire me and my gloriousness while they fix my... All right, so tonight we are going to celebrate our big awards winners, and we're so happy for all of them. That's the first thing that we're going to do. And then, after all that business is done, we are going to roll out our joy and our boogie, woogie, woogie, and we're going to party, okay? We're going to get our party on. Now, I know it's P-A-R-T-Y, but if you're really cool and you really got soul, how do you say it? One more time. Thank you very much. The Quan Howell Project will be performing your favorite R&B and danceable tunes, and 8 elite Dance Academy dancers are going to be with us to make sure that the dance floor is hot and hopping. And all of this happens immediately after the awards show, but that's not all, because we have an alluring array of arts experiences planned for you. An arts marketplace, I want to make sure I get all this in, an arts marketplace with our arts festival, big local arts artists. There's a swag room with all sorts of fun GCAC stickers and pins and buttons and other items like paper roses and mini donuts. In other words, all the stuff left over from the arts festival. They didn't have no place to put it, so they said, we'll roll it out on Big Arts Night. Hey, there you go. That was a Tom Katzenmeyer idea, by the way. A cafe de joie experience with poets, a DJ and visual artist led by the beautiful and soulful Caroline Inspires, fresh popcorn in our award winner theater, a sensory room, and more. It sounds almost decadent, doesn't it? And that's why you're all here. So just a few housekeeping things. One, please silence your phones. Don't make me come out there with my new scepter. How do you like my scepter? It's heavy, and it will leave a mark. I've tried it out on the people backstage, and you will not be seeing them this evening. We just don't want anything ringing during our program. And then on a similar note, okay, applause and cheering and sharing joy and love for everybody on the stage and all our winners. We really encourage that, highly encourage that. But we discourage any aggressive behaviors or disruptions to the show, because those are the kinds of things, not only are they unfair to everybody in the house, but they are also the kinds of things that your queen will delegate to the large and hunky security men to handle. I have checked out all these hunky security men. They are capable of removing you from the theater. Finally, if you're having fun, and we know that you will, please do all those social media thingies that I really and truly don't understand, the posty things about hash browns and Big Arts Night, and share your photos and your memories. Yeah, go on. So, our time here in the Southern will be fast-paced. We like it that way because we're heading straight into it right now so that we can get to the party. Each of our presenters and award winners will join us on stage as we go along, and then in a very short 51 minutes, I added a minute, Jamie, just deal with it. In an amazingly short 51 minutes, we will all dance our way off the stage and next door to celebrate. Now, before we get to our first award, I invite our Jim Arter Arts Educator and Dale Hadeloff Award winners to begin to make their way to the area backstage to my, is that my left? Is that, yeah, Pledge Allegiance, yeah, to the left. And there are steps over there somewhere, I don't know. I don't care, I don't have to use them. So, we do love our surprises, you know that if you've been here before. Both the Michael B. Coleman Arts Partner and Excellence winners are unknown, except for a handful of people, and they have been threatened with silence, because we all like surprises and we want everybody to enjoy in the sheer surprise of those announcements. So we're gonna bring all the award winners upstage as we go. They will sit behind me and just basically enjoy all my gloriousness from behind, I guess. I don't know. I think it's rude, but you know, I didn't plan all this. And we'll show the reward, the award rather, that they will be receiving. For our award winners, we just ask that you stay on stage for us after, so that we can take lots of photos. Just take a seat and we'll just keep right on moving, okay? Is that okay? Say yes, Angela. All right. So now I'm about to take a brief break, but before I leave you in the capable hands and the soothing tones of GCAC President and CEO Tom Katzenmeyer, or Tom Terrific as I like to call him, gotta talk about my new crown and my scepter, designed by Logan Baldoff. I hope I said your last name right, Logan. Logan, y'all know Logan? Clap for Logan. Did he do a spectacular job or what? Because normally I will go to like Walmart or someplace and just buy a crown for $5.99 and, you know, stick it on my head, and y'all don't know. Y'all appreciate it anyway. But this is designed just for me, and I think he did a fabulous job in a matching scepter, and I plan to take this wherever I go. Okay, now let's talk about the gown. Shall we talk about the gown? First of all, I am so unused to wearing heels. I've been wearing Chucks, like, for the last year and a half, so to have even a little heel, but I had to do this gown justice. This was designed by the amazing Joan Madison. And it's amazing because Joan was one of our winners last year, and she came up on stage and took her seat, and at the end of the program, she came up to me and said, "Next year, I got something for you." And she is a woman of her word, because this is, and Joan, I know that I frustrated the hell out of you, because I don't like standing still, and she was sticking pins and stuff, and I felt like a voodoo doll, and I thought, this is making me uncomfortable. But she did a fabulous job, and I just want to thank her so much for creating this for me. Tom has on couture as well. Do you believe it? Tom Katzenmeyer is wearing a custom-designed outfit. Wait till you see him in it. I don't know, Tom, you want to join me out here or what? You going to wait? Okay, all right. I guess he wants to make an entrance too. Tom's suit was designed by Esther Sands. So now, there you go. Give Esther some love. Now, you know, we love our crazy ideas at GCAC, especially for this night. So we want to thank Celeste Malvern Stewart, who is a Celeste, where are you? You're out there somewhere. She's a GCAC board member and incredible fashion designer. So we created... Don't you want to just say, Bond, James Bond? Ooh, you so pretty.
Thank you.
You are just gorgeous. So let me tell you why Tom and I are dressed like this, okay? We created a little fashion and technology experiment with six Columbus-based designers and allowed folks, can you see them? Where are they? Oh, there they are. Okay, thank you. There they are. To vote for their favorite Angela and Tom fashions to wear at Big Arts Night. Now, I love all my designs. I said, can I just have all of them and do like a Tyra Banks and just change clothes every 5 minutes or so? I understand that all the votes for the outfits were very, very close. More than 250 people voted, Tom. 250 people out there. I want to thank all the designers. You're all incredibly, incredibly talented, so professional, and they were really good sports about it, too. So how about a round of applause for all the designers who created our outfits? Okay, so I have things to do.
Yes.
So I'm going to let you just take over and do whatever it is you get paid to do for the next few minutes.
Thank you.
And then I'll be back. I've got to go find a runway to walk.
Thank you, Angela. Thank you, Esther. I know you're out there somewhere, but let's give a round of applause for Esther Sands. It was nerve-wracking. There were other choices, and I'm very happy with my suit. I just want you to know that. All my designs were amazing, too. One was a little bit out there, and actually, I think my whole staff voted for this one. It was sort of a Ziggy Stardust-type look. That did not win. The vote was not, you know, not illegal. It was a legitimate vote. But this is what the people wanted, so thank you. And Angela and I look good in our blues. I want to welcome everyone to Big Arts Night. We're so pleased you're here to celebrate all the incredible work being done every day by our artists and arts organizations, from music to visual arts, film to fashion, literature, dance. Together we're all bringing national recognition to the arts in Columbus. So we're going to do three things tonight. Number one, we're going to give out and recognize more than $265,000 in cash and other awards. You can applaud for that, yes. Number two, as Angela was just saying, we've got a big party next door upstairs at the Westin, in honor of and as a thanks to all of you. Each year I wonder how we're going to top the previous party. Angela talked a little bit about this. We've got music, dancing, a special cafe de joie with poets, DJs, and visual arts, a chance to shop our arts festival, big local artists. It is not the leftover stuff from the arts festival, that she said, and lots of fun swag for you to take home, including, this is important, vote positive messages for you and your friends. Which leads me to my third point. We're going to give you a message of hope, joy, and empowerment in these tumultuous times. The election is just 10 short days away, perhaps one of the most important of our lifetimes. I know you all get this. On the ballot are not just candidate choices, but choices that impact the future of our city, state, county, but also issues. Each of us has a voice. You have a voice. We've got a voice. That's why GCAC has endorsed a yes vote for issue 47 for Link Us. The future of accessible transit for all our community members. So I cannot stress important enough the importance of making a plan to vote if you haven't already. Now, I know I'm preaching to the choir about this, but if you haven't already voted, there's plenty of time. We created this campaign. I give Jamie Goldstein credit for it. Arts Vote Ohio. It's gone all over the state. We've got wonderful graphics. Encourage your friends, family, and personal networks to make a plan to vote. So tonight is our night to say thank you to our community, our elected officials at the city and the county, and their ongoing support. But first, there's a lot of good folks I want to thank by name. And these are our financial sponsors and production sponsors. They are Bath & Body Works, PNC, Mills James, Kappa, Zen Genius, Nick and Donna Akins, and Dale Haidloff. Let's give a round of applause for all of them. We are fortunate in Columbus and Franklin County to also have tremendous support for the arts from our elected officials, so I can't go another minute without thanking them. So Mayor Andrew Ginther, City Council President Shannon Harden, Council Member and President Pro Tem Rob Dorrance, Council Members Nicholas Bankston, Lourdes Barroso de Padilla, Nancy De Ackauer, see you here sitting in the front, Shayla's here right down front too, Emmanuel Remy, Melissa Green, and Chris Weish, and Franklin County Commissioners President Kevin Boyce, down in front, Erica Crawley, and John O'Grady. I also want to thank Judge Eileen Paley for being here with us a long time. Actually, I think the longest service on the GCAC board in multiple roles. And also, I think County Auditor Michael Stinziano is here with us tonight, too. So will you all the elected officials, please stand and be recognized. Next, our deepest thanks to the hardest working board in town, the GCAC board members, and I want the former board members to stand too. I see Michael Bongiorno here, Barbara Brandt is here, Karen Bell is here. Will you all please stand for a round of applause? Pam O'Grady down in front here, and then the crew that put this together. They're scattered behind me, out in the back upstairs at the Westin, the staff, Jamie especially. I don't know whether we can get Jamie to step out here for a second. So Jamie, can we give Jamie a round of applause? Jamie Goldstein.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It was having a conversation.
All right. I'm done. We're going back to the show. We've got a lot of money to give out tonight, and I'll see you upstairs at the party. Thanks. Yep.
I'm sorry. I was back there admiring myself. This is a lot, isn't it? I mean, those of you who really know me know this is a lot for me, but I am loving every second of it. I have missed sequins. How did I know sequins were what I was supposed to be wearing all these years? Thank you so much, Tom. Really appreciate that. Now, our next award, I love this one. Our next award is near and dear to my heart because it's named after one of my very, very favorite people on the planet, Jim Arter. Jim, I know that you're here. There you are, Jim Arter, right over there. Jim has done so much good work in the arts education field for decades. And so we decided last year to name this award after him, Into Infinity and Beyond. It will forever be known as the Jim Arter Award. Now, sadly, BHB, who is our winner this year of the Jim Arter Arts Educator Award, could not be with us tonight because he's out art educating somewhere. He is one of the hardest working mentors and educators in town. He's been mentoring young people in dance, in hip hop, and in life for more than 25 years. And he's out doing that somewhere tonight as well. This is not a man who will rest on his laurels, and he's going to try and join us for the party later on. So let's just give a round of applause to BHB. We know he'll hear us. Our next award is presented in the name of one of my favorite people on the planet, another one, and I call him my bad little brother, Michael B. Coleman. So he decided he was going to grace us with his presence this evening because I threatened him, so that he could be here to present the award that is named in his honor. Ladies and gentlemen, again, one of my favorite people on the planet, Michael B. Coleman. Oh, don't do that. That is so amateur. Don't do that. Oh.
My queen.
You're not going to be able to get back up.
I know. Help. Somebody help me up. Oh. Oh, my goodness gracious. Angela. It's so wonderful to see you again.
Well, thank you so much.
She is my queen. All of our queens. And it's amazing. Year after year, you reign supreme.
Yes, I do.
With a new crown every year. For this great event, Tom must really like you.
I got something on Tom.
Yes. Oh, you too, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. It's been almost 10 years since GCAC created this special award, and I'm still honored to be able to play such a small part in recognizing the incredible leadership in our community of arts. GCAC is an organization that gets things done. How about that? They do. They get things done. And they do it with the help of creative, passionate arts warriors like our award winners tonight.
So Tom told me that you wanted this award to be a surprise.
Totally surprise.
Absolutely.
100%.
And I think we've been able to do that.
Yes.
Keep it under wraps, except for those of us who had to know on a need-to-know basis.
Yes, and you are one of those need-to-know basis,
yes,
right?
I am a need-to-know basis.
That's right, because you are the queen.
I am the queen. I got a crown.
Yes, you do. This award is special. It recognized not only because it's named the Michael B. Coleman Arts Award, it also recognizes outstanding civic and community leadership that has been a long time steward and a partner of Columbus and Central Ohio cultural community, giving time and treasure to Columbus arts and artists. And this year, I have to say, it's going to be someone who's been quietly serving the arts in the background for far too long. Well, maybe not always as quiet, but definitely a true public servant.
Absolutely. So there are so many quiet warriors for the arts working every single day here in Columbus. But still, one person stood out against the crowd for you and for the GCAC board. Someone who has been a champion for years, a champion of the arts here in Columbus.
It's true. We love this person so much.
How much, Michael?
So much. This much. Working always in the background, showing up at all the cool events, walking with a little swagger, dressing up for every fancy fundraiser, but never asking for accolades and always giving accolades. In fact, this person is so important that GCAC commissioned two, not one, but two special pieces of art to present to them tonight. Would my assistant award presenters join us on stage right now? First, a painting by April Tsunami. Whoa. Look at that. Stand right here. You know who this is, right? Mm-hmm. Downtown Mike Brown.
Downtown.
And second, just stand right here. And second, a special song written just for this moment by the great Quan Howell.
Ooh, Quan.
You are a shining star. The world doesn't realize how beautiful you are. Your record shows so many things you've done and things unknown. This moment's for you. Oh. The arts has made a space for the great Angela Payne. The heart has made a space for the great Angela Payne.
Friends of GCAC, leaders and artists, please join me in honoring this year's outstanding warrior, the Queen, for all the arts partners, my own baby big sister, Angela Pace. Yeah.
Wait.
It's you, sister. Come on. This is yours.
No, wait, this is not.
No, this is, come on over here. Take a picture.
Wait, this is not in the script.
I know it. That's right. This was only for those who needed to know. And you did not need to know this. Remember I asked you that question?
Yeah, you did.
We love you, darling.
Oh, my God.
You're so deserving of this. You're always, you're going to make me cry. Damn it, stop. You're always setting everybody else up, holding them up, talking about how great they are. Well, I'm here to tell you, you are great. We love you, and you deserve this award more than anybody I've ever known. And I'm so glad it's named the Michael B. Coleman Arts Partner Award.
Oh. Did y'all know?
Everybody knew but you.
Everybody but me.
I've never heard you speechless, and I love it.
I've never been speechless. This, you guys don't know how much this means. This means so much. First of all, I love this organization. I love GCAC. I hated it when Tom Casimari kicked me off the board. But I still work for him. Anytime Tom or Jamie asked me to do anything, I'm going to do it. And that's the arts. I mean, Kappa, Lincoln Theater Association, oh my God, I can't believe I'm crying.
It's from the heart.
Strange people. and I do mean strange. I love the arts, and I love making sure that they are available to every damn body.
Yes.
Everybody needs to have access to the arts.
Yes.
And we need to make sure that all our babies grow up loving the arts. Please, if you don't do anything else for me tonight, make sure that our babies have access to the arts and that they grow up loving and appreciating the arts as much as I do.
That's why we love you.
Oh, God.
That's why we... This is a standing ovation.
Oh, man.
For the queen.
Oh.
The queen. Let me see you stand up. Yes.
I don't believe you did this. Oh, my God.
All right.
I what are we supposed to do now?
No, I got, that's on me.
Oh, do I?
No, you just be quiet.
Mike,
downtown Mike Brown.
That's why you're not my lawyer anymore.
That's right. You fired me a long time ago. Mike Brown, come back out here. So, this is double bluff. Mike came out here to present an award to the Queen. And Mike, you know how much I consider you as one of my favorite people in the world. I've known Mike Brown since he was not downtown Mike Brown. He was just a little kid working on my campaign, running for a statewide office, and we worked together. And you are a tireless crusader for the arts. A little quieter than Angela.
Who isn't?
But you are truly an arts partner, and we would like to name and would like you to be knighted tonight by Queen Angela of the Arts Partner.
You.
So, Angela, here's your
scepter.
Hammer.
Is that a hammer? Oh, my God. He's from Toledo. You can't take
him
nowhere.
Get down. Go ahead and smack him upside his head.
Downtown Mike Brown, you know, we've known each other longer than the mayor and you have known one another. Because Mike Brown, if you didn't know, is a journalist, or was a journalist for years, and we worked together at 10TV. He was an ONN, a young guy trying to make a name for himself, and then he moved on up to this guy. Well, you know, it's all in your perception and your perspective, I guess. But Mike Brown, you know, I absolutely adore you. You will always be my downtown. You'll always be my Miami Vice bodyguard in the Doodah Parade. And I love you and love your energy and just love your spirit so very much. So I knight you, the, with a capital D, downtown Mike Brown.
And wait a minute now. We got something
there
for
you.
Come on over, Jamie. Another art award from April Tsunami to you, Michael. We love you. We thank you.
Hey, Mike.
And you don't get enough recognition out there because you always work in the background. Now it's time to step forward. There you go, man.
Yay, Mike.
All right. So am I done?
I hope so, because I can't take any more of this. I hope they've got Grey Goose upstairs.
Yeah, they got some. Just for you. God bless you. I love you, everybody. Thank you, Mike.
Love you. Thank you. Okay. I'm going to keep moving because I don't know what else to do at this point. So here to introduce our, I keep holding this thing like it's a microphone. Can you tell how old school I am? Here to introduce our next awards is another one of my very, very favorite people, a woman near and dear to many of you. I know this for a fact. A true servant leader here in Columbus is doing a tremendous job now for nonprofits by finding great people for great jobs. And she serves as the chair of GCAC's board. Ladies and gentlemen, again, one of my favorites, Christy Angel.
Here I am. I don't have any special outfits. They left me out of that. I am that person, I'm the one who, you know what the Grammys and the Oscars are like, and here's from our accountants. That's me. So I'm about to go through the accounting of GCAC, but thank you, Angela. Thank you to my former boss, always will be my boss, Michael B. Coleman. Give him another round of applause. Mike Brown, who was my colleague, and of course, Angela, who was my board colleague, all of you who deserve these awards, and to BHB, who wasn't here tonight, also, you know, they're out educating, but to them as well. It is a great day to be here. But our our reason for being here tonight is mostly to thank everyone. It is about the awards, but it also is about our annual public forum. Our annual public forum is a free event where we report on some of GCAC's work in the past year. So remember, I'm that accountant. I'm the one that has to give you all the policies and the rules and all that good stuff. Some things just hold true, Kevin Boyce, to like what I've been doing for all of my life, right? It doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. So I'll keep the facts and figures brief. The true picture of our work will be revealed in our annual report in 2025, in the spring. But 2024 has been a record year for grants to organizations and artists with GCAC. We awarded nearly $12.8 million to 38 organizations in operating and general support, and more than 600,000 to more than 1,200 artists in the Funds for Artists program. 637 of those were completely new to GCAC, and I want to say a big thank you to our grants team, Allison Barrett, Mackenzie Swinehart, the finance team, the entire team, and our navigators, people who kind of move around the community and identify potential grants recipients, navigators. It is this kind of support that is generating a new vibrancy for the cultural sector in Columbus, bringing visitors to our city, helping to attract and retain talented creatives and businesses, because we are part of the economic vitality of this community. And then there's the new GCAC website. You know, I talked about that last year, got to talk about it again this year because, you know, it's a great website and we launched it, and it helped us improve our services to the community, to our grantees, by connecting them directly to the appropriate staff people, by connecting them directly to the funding, resource information, all the things that all of our grantees need now exist on our website, right? So we had to come into this century, and no slight on you, Tom, but you know, we had to come into this century with all of our resources and all of the things that we offer. And our website now translates every single part of every single one of our web pages, including all of our grant guidelines, into 8 languages.
I need this?
Really? Well, I'm kind of loud. I didn't think I needed this. Okay. So this is just a small part of GCAC's continued commitment to DEI, diversity, equity, inclusion. We are not letting that go out of our vocabulary. Sorry, just got to say that. This is intentional, and it is at the forefront of all of our work across all of our programs. This past year, we've been hard at work on our public art plan for Columbus and Franklin County, and I'm proud to announce that we are on track to roll it out before the end of the year, along with a new website to connect artists, community members, and neighborhoods across the county with resources, including funding, to make more public art in more spaces in our city and our county. Stay tuned as we roll this out in December for more news. Besides tonight, our other signature event this year, the Columbus Arts Festival, had one of the most perfect years on record. We know we have the best arts festival, right? We are grateful that we have also regularly hear the same from the same exhibiting artists, performers and patrons, but this year, we continued our work to make the festival more accessible to all members of our community with the addition of the Momentum Refresh restroom that allows restroom access to those with with mobility devices and adult changing needs, a sensory tent in partnership with the Autism Society of Central Ohio, and more. We showcased all Columbus-based music lineup, 4 stages, 80 performing artists, and the festival generated an estimated $2.5 million in artist sales and record-breaking beverage sales. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Had one of those before I got on this stage. Record-breaking beverage sales that allowed the nonprofit organizations that work with us to earn about $73,000 in tips. Without the artists, we could not have done this. Without the volunteers, we could not have done this. And without the sponsors that make this festival possible, we could not have the arts festival that we have in this community. The premier event, first weekend in June, second weekend in June, something like that, where we kind of kick off summer. Be sure to save the date for next year's festival, June 6th through 8th, and I encourage you to check out our artist marketplace at the Party Next Door, featuring artists who have been exhibiting and organizing our big local arts marketplace since 2012. By the way, our arts festival was so bad that that Mirfield went back to their original date. Because, you know, that's how it works. No diss to our golfers out there, but I'm just saying. Now, I have the pleasure of bringing back a longtime community leader and philanthropist who continues to care and support for the arts in Columbus, which includes his support for these next awards, the Dale E. Heidloff Community Arts Innovation Awards. Dale? And I just want to say one thing. I'm not chair next year. So next year, if y'all have some kind of special outfit for the chair, and it's Jim Negron and not me, we're going to have something to talk about, Tom Katzenmeyer. Dale, take it away.
Thank you, Christy, and good evening, everyone. Innovation. It's essential for artistic organizations because it helps to capture the imagination of audiences, and it drives artistic achievement and expression. I was absolutely thrilled when I was informed this year that over 12 nominations were submitted for this award. And I know that the work of the committee in selecting winners was especially difficult. Our first award recipient tonight is Opera Columbus's Cranes Directing Fellowship and Directorship, which helps to foster the talents of Black, Indigenous, and people of color directors. The CEO of Opera Columbus, Julia Newhall Marant, is here tonight to accept the award, and she told me backstage something wonderful, something we should all be very proud of, that Columbus is the only city in America with an African-American opera director. Julia? Our second Community Arts Innovation Award winner tonight is a program that is helping young Black musicians all around Columbus, Urban Strings, Strings Out of the Box, which meets young musicians wherever they're at, culturally and musically, and encourages them to consider a career in music. Catherine Willis is the founder of Urban Strings. She's with us tonight to accept the award. We'll go back there.
I'm sorry, I cried all my makeup off, so I was back there trying to put myself back together. But I want to say a special thank you to my friend Christy Angel. Thank you so much, Christy. I know that great things are happening at GCAC, and I can't wait to see what both you and our award winners are going to be up to next. And to Dale, we're very grateful. Where is Dale? Hi. And Miss Catherine. That's my Shiro right there. I'm just so excited to be on the same stage with her. All right, so we are coming into the home stretch. I promise it won't be much longer. Just a few more minutes and then it will be party time. So earlier, Tom talked about the $265,000 in prizes tonight, and our next award recipients are a really big part of that. In 2021, we launched a program that is not just groundbreaking here in Columbus, but all across the country. For the first 2 years, our Artist Elevated Awards provided $20,000 in cash to two mid-career artists who were poised to go on to the next level. Last year, we increased that amount to 5 awards. And this year, we are proud to announce a total of 7, right? Yeah, 7 awards, 1 in each of the major arts disciplines. Now, the funds for these awards are made possible with the many contributions to our endowment, including those from major donors like Nick and Donna Akins. Thank you again to Nick and Donna. So this year, we have increased not just the number of awards to 7, but also the amount of each award to $25,000. $25,000. So artists are invited to apply through a community nomination process that recommends artists in 7 disciplines for this program. So a national jury selects 2 finalists in each discipline and then does the incredibly hard work of narrowing that pool to 7 award winners. And each finalist will receive $1,500. So there is cash just flowing around this place tonight. So I want to start by asking the 2024 Artist Elevated finalists who are with us tonight to stand and to be recognized. James Fillmore. James over there. Joey Hebdo. Joey. Andrew Johnson. Ann McGreevy. Ann. Lubna Najjar. Chineze Opalaka. And Matthew Sierra. Let's give them all a round of applause. Congratulations. And now to introduce you to our 2024 Artist Elevated recipients. And again, thanks to Nick and Donna Akins for supporting these awards. Antoine T. Clark. Gerardo Encinas. Orlando Hunter Valentine. Travis Chi Wing Lau. Christopher Leva. Andrea Myers. And Mike Olenek, who couldn't be with us tonight, but we're sure he's here in spirit. So all right, let's hear it for this incredible artist. Congratulations to all of you. Oh, look, you got a standing O. We want to thank each and every one of our Artist Elevated recipients and the finalists because we cannot wait to see what your creativity is going to bring to us next. Do not disappoint us. Somewhere back there, I have a scepter. So, yeah. Our final individual award this evening is the 16th recipient of the Raymond J. Hanley Award, named after the longtime president and CEO of GCAC and a great friend. And we lost Ray in 2006. The proceeds from the sale of his incredible art collection went into an endowment, and that endowment has been supporting this award since 2009. The award of $15,000 is given each year to an artist who has demonstrated a high level of achievement and has lived in Columbus for at least 5 years. Here to present this year's award is my favorite commissioner in the whole wide world, Franklin County Commission, I'm sorry, John. He made me say it. I'm sorry. My favorite commissioner in the whole wide world, Franklin County Commission President Kevin Boyce.
You got that right.
I know.
Thank you to Angela in her cape, and I know John may want to borrow that one day. Our Hanley Award recipient this evening really needs no introduction. He's been performing for years all over the globe, but he calls Columbus home and is the longest serving artistic director of the Jazz Arts Group as well as a virtuoso trumpet player, singer, actor, and so much more. Please welcome Byron Stripling. I understand this award is particularly poignant for Byron in that Ray Henley was the very first conversation that you had when you moved here to Columbus. Congratulations. Oh, he said Doug Kreidler, who's back there in the back, and then Ray Henley. So, all the none, congratulations. I think you take the stage.
I'm not smiling at you, I'm smiling at him. I know, thank you so much. Did I make up to it? Okay, hi Byron. I'm sorry, but I love this man too. So many of my favorite people are in the house tonight, I'm so excited. All right, the end is nigh, I promise. I know I say that every time I come out here, but you know, I have absolutely no credibility anymore. Look what I'm wearing. We have two more awards before we turn you loose next door to Eat, Drink, and Be Merry. So to present these two awards, I invite, against my better judgment, Columbus City Council members and GCAC board members, Lourdes Barroso de Padilla, and thank you, I've been practicing, and Emmanuel Remy to join me on the stage.
Congratulations, Auntie!
Oh, I gotta give a hug to my neighbor.
Thank you.
Big award winner.
Yeah, we hang out in Wylands in Clintonville all the time. So I'm really, really surprised they had you guys back because y'all cut up. Now, you know what you did last year. Y'all cut up. You didn't do anything I told you to do. You just acted like it was your show. So let me just let you know that you are allowed back here only if you behave yourselves.
I mean, I will do my best. I can't speak for this
okay.
one.
Okay.
We're
going to soldier through this, and anything that they do, I ain't got nothing to do with it, okay? It's just on them. So now the moment that we've all been waiting for. We do love ending the evening with a little bit of suspense for you. We're going to present the Columbus Makes Art Excellence Awards and two more surprises this evening. The winners now receive $20,000, and each of the two finalists, yeah, that's a lot of moolah, and then each of the two finalists get $2,500. I boosted it up. Tom just passed out back there. $2,500. So these awards go to organizations with a budget of under $1 million and organizations with a budget of $1 million and over. The awards are for programming that epitomizes innovation, risk, and excellence. Organizations with budgets of under $1 million. 934 Gallery for Pay Artists. Columbus Cultural Orchestra for Black History Month Outreach Tour. Education Foundation for Freedom for 2024 Columbus Women and Girls Fest. Lourdes, it's all you.
Uh-oh. Just kidding, I'm gonna follow directions. And the winner of the 2024 Columbus Arts Excellence Award in the category of budgets under $1 million is 934 Gallery Pay Artists. Oh, wait, pose for pictures.
That's right, thank you.
Who's taking your picture? That follow directions was light. Okay, may we have the next category, please?
Organizations with budgets of $1 million and over. Kappa for Walk with Amal. Woo! Columbus Symphony for Nas with the Columbus Symphony. Lincoln Theater Association for Performing Arts Design and Development Initiative.
And now, Manuel, you will have the honor this time.
I was told to be good, so I'm going to do that. So, our final award for this evening, the winner of the 2024 Columbus Arts Excellence Award in category of budgets, $1 million and over, the Lincoln Theaters Association's Performing Arts Design and Development Initiative. Woo! Angela, wrap us up, please.
All right, I will. Congratulations.
Say that.
Thank you very much to our council members. You did a great job following instructions, and so you will be allowed to come back next year. Well, no, you'll be allowed to compete to come back for next year. I'm going to make this.
It's better when we're back.
I know. So we want to congratulate all our winners. You can watch videos of our award winners and catch other moments of joy in the Seneca Room in the West End. Can we have another round of applause for the amazing people up here? That's what always makes this such a special night for me, is to realize just how much talent, how much damn talent we have in this town, and how many people are willing to share their talents with all of us, and how many people are willing to support those artists who share their talents with all of us. So thank you to all of our sponsors and everyone else who helped to make tonight happen. Party time, y'all. See GCAC staff for your drink tickets, as we say in my hood. As you move into the hotel, pick up a free glass of bubbly, it's not apple juice, in the Seneca Room on the lobby level, or head right upstairs for great art, food, and drink. And now, see if y'all remember, it's time to pâté. All right. Thank you so much for being here.